Well, hello everyone. Stephen Whiteside here. Hope you're having a wonderful weekend. This is Protect Your Portfolio for week 48, 2016. I'm going to be rather quick today, not a lot to talk about, but there are a couple of charts you should be aware of. First of all, and we're going to start off looking at a couple of daily charts before we get to the weekly charts. The S&P 500 may have peaked on Wednesday. We put in a bearish reversal day, and then we got to follow through to the downside on Thursday. So that's what the top of a market looks like. Friday was fairly quiet trading. For the first time since the election, we're trading back in the channel, and a close below Friday's low would give us a sell signal on Monday, a daily sell signal. Now, at the same time we were seeing downward pressure in the S&P 500, we saw some upward pressure in the VIX, and on Thursday we generated a buy signal, and of course a buy signal for the VIX is negative for stocks going forward. Now, since the election, the U.S. dollar index has been on a tear, and that looks like it's coming to an end as well. Again, a close below Friday's low would give us a sell signal on Monday. Now, big reversal in oil. Tuesday, we actually closed below the lower channel line. Wednesday morning, we came in and saw the futures were up sharply in the pre-market and had a complete reversal. We have not taken out the October highs, so there is still a level of resistance up there, but higher crude oil prices have helped move the Canadian dollar higher over the past couple of days. Now, looking at weekly charts, there's the S&P 500 down 21 and change on the week, still on a buy signal, of course. Now, we've been trying to break away from the 2187.50 level. We have not done that yet. We've traded above it, but we haven't broken away from it. Next target to the upside, if we can do that, is 2250, but it doesn't look like we're going to be able to do that right now. We had a weekly bearish reversal signal this week, on top of the daily bearish reversal signal that we had on Wednesday. Of course, to confirm this weekly bearish reversal signal, we need next week, the coming week, to close lower. And so that hasn't happened yet, of course. So this is the first sign of a top being put in place. If you look at who's in control, the pros look like they're just about to give up control. So we really didn't see a lot of excitement, even though prices were rising substantially over the past couple of weeks. It's really just been in the bank stocks that investors have been focusing over the last few weeks. The NASDAQ was down on the week and has not put in a higher high as some of the other indexes have. And so that's a major area of concern. We'll have to see if the NASDAQ keeps leading the market lower. What's been going on is that the NASDAQ, which of course we've always looked at as the leadership index that technology stocks should lead, we've had rotation into bank stocks over the past couple of weeks, but that may be coming to an end. And certainly the pros have been getting out of technology stocks over the past couple of weeks. There's the Dow Jones Banking Index, had another positive week, but it looks like things are slowing down up here. And so we'll have to see how long this interest in bank stocks lasts. There's the pros, and it looks like they're very overextended at the moment. Certainly no sign that anything is breaking down. We're just anticipating what could happen. And, you know, anytime that you're looking at stocks in an uptrend, the first thing that I look for is, did we close below the previous week's low? That certainly did not happen this week, but that's the first thing I would look for as an indication that a trend is starting to stop. And that is certainly not the case for the TSX Financial Services Index, which did close lower on the week, but did not close below the previous week's low. Now, the TSX itself had a negative week. It closed down just 22 points and change, so no big deal there. We are trying to break away from 15,000, and just like the S&P 500, we have not been able to do that just yet. Break away from 15,000 means that the low of the week is higher than 15,000, and we have not been able to do that. Now, crude oil was up sharply last week, has not taken out the recent highs. If we can do that, our next mathematical target is 62.50. If you look over to the left-hand side of the screen, you'll see that we had a lot of activity between 60 and 62.50 a while ago, and that is, of course, the market is going to remember that, and that's going to be a target and an area of resistance. And if we can break out above the recent highs, that would start to take us out of the flypaper channel, and that would take us above the 100-week moving average, heading towards the 200-week moving average. And look at where the 200-week moving average is. It's just above $60 and closing, down towards $60. So that is a legitimate target to the upside. The 60, 62.50 level, that's where I think crude oil will go if we take out the recent high. Now, gold was down once again last week, and we're still holding on to the 1187.50 level. If we break away from that, if the high of next week is below 1187.50, then look for a move down to 1125. And then, of course, below that is a significant target down at 1062.50. Moving in the opposite direction, copper. Now, copper was closed lower this week, but again, I would ask you to look and see, did we close below the previous week's low? And if you look at copper, you know, since this rally started, each week we have not penetrated and closed below the previous week's low. And so that's the first sign that something new could be happening. It is not a sell signal, but it is certainly an indication that the chairs on the deck could be shifting if you start to see a close below the previous week's low. Okay, folks, that is all for today's presentation. We could have put in a top last Wednesday. We did see fall through to the downside on Thursday. Last week may have been a top for the S&P 500. We do have a daily and a weekly bearish reversal signal. We do have a new buy signal for the VIX. So it is certainly possible that we've put in a top here, and we should be looking for lower prices. Have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again soon.